Welcome to our presentation of the Skylight Room by Oak Hattery. The summary. It's about a protagonist named Miss Leeson. She is a typist that rents a room at the boarding house of Mrs. R. Miss Leeson is not very rich, so that is why she rents the smallest room in the house available. The room is on the top floor and has a skylight. Miss Leeson often chats in the evening with other guests of the parlor outside on the porch. One evening, she sees a star in the sky and names it Billy Jackson, for which she has a discussion with the other women. In the story, Miss Leeson is in a very difficult time. She loses her job, which results in not being able to pay for the rent of the room and not being able to pay for life maintenance, such as one day after she had spent the whole day looking for work, she came home so exhausted and starved from not eating for a very long time that one of the guests wanted offered to marry her. Miss Leeson rejects the offer because she wanted to stay true to herself. When collapsing on the bed, she looked at the star she named Billy Jackson. When Miss Leeson did not answer a maid knocking the door the next morning, the maid breaks in and needs to revive Miss Leeson. This attempt failed. Okay, and this is why she needed to go to the hospital by ambulance. The story ends with Miss Leeson being saved by a doctor named Dr. William Billy Jackson.
The writer of the story. William Sidney Portner, better known as O. Henry, was the writer of The Skylight Room. He was born in 1862 in America. As a kid, he lived in North Carolina, and later he moved to Texas. After the death of his first wife in 1902, he moved to New York. In this city, he wrote hundreds of short stories. He often wrote about ordinary people who lived in New York, and he was famous for surprising endings. The reader will recognize O. Henry's writing style very clear in this short story.
Then next, we are going to analyze the story.
Yes. Like I said before, most of O. Henry's stories are in New York City. The Skylight Room is too. It probably takes place around the 19th and 20th century. The narrator. The narrator is a third-person neutral point of view. He only tells the events like it's through a camera or on stage. The readers don't know what is going on in the minds of the characters.
The theme and the plot. The main theme of the story is poverty. Miss Leeson is very poor, and that is why she needs to rent the cheapest room available. Her struggle to even finance the small room eventually leads to not being able to pay for food as well. This struggle leads to starvation and almost killed Miss Leeson. Another theme of the story is the reality of life, which describes how hard life can actually be, and that there sometimes is a big difference between rich and poor. As an example, Miss Leeson, who is poor, rents a room in the parlor of the rich Mrs. Parker.
The characters. The main character is Miss Leeson. She is a flat character. She doesn't really change in her behavior or as a person. Other characters like Mrs. Parker, Miss Longnecker, and William Jackson are not described that detailed so that you could see any changes. They are flat too. Motives, symbols, and illusions. One symbol is a skylight in the room of Miss Leeson. The skylight stands for hope in a poor or sober situation. Another symbol is the star that Miss Leeson sees through the skylight. She called the star Billy Jackson. The star also stands for hope and for her future. After Miss Leeson got sick, a doctor named William Jackson came. His name is linked with the name of the star. He is the one who gives hope for a future. The next linear I'm going to read for you is very important for the meaning of the story. You could see that William Jackson apparently something told to mislead him. On the first landing, she met him, coming back bearing the astronomer in his arm, in his arms. He stopped and let loose the practiced scuffle of a stone, not loudly. Gradually, Mrs. Parker crumpled as a stiff garment that slips down from a nail. Even afterward, the remained crumples in her mind and body. Sometimes her curious rumors would ask her what the doctor said to her. Let that be, she would answer. If I can get forgiveness for having heard it, I will be satisfied. William Jackson seemed to already know Miss Leeson before the accident happened. When he saw her, he told her something, which made her satisfied with her life. But we couldn't find out what William Jackson told her.
The mood. The story is written in a kind of sad but also hopeful way. The situation of Miss Leeson is sad, of course, because she is very poor. She has to work hard to pay for food and a place to live, which isn't even possible by the end of the story, and results in starvation and near death. On the other hand, hopeful is always also a way in which you can describe the story, because even though the story is about Miss Leeson struggling to pay for her daily necessities, it gives hope that her life gets saved at the end of the story.
How did we like the story? This story was very hard to read. The Scarlet Room does have a difficult writing style, and we thought it was a very challenging story to make a presentation about. But it was actually exciting to take this challenge and to find out what the meaning was of the ending of the story. There's not much information written about the Scarlet Room on the internet, so we need to find out a lot of info by ourselves.
Yes, I agree with Tim that I often had to read something twice because the way the story was written was pretty hard to understand sometimes, but I eventually managed to read and mostly understand the story. Finding the meaning of the book, for example, was a sometimes hard job because, as Tim said, there was not much information available about the book. This was our presentation. Thank you for listening.